Hi everyone, I'm Alex Pilarski, broker owner of RE/MAX Realtron. One of the most important things in our business is brand name recognition. And I understand you want to build your own brand, but what I want to encourage you to do is to build your brand alongside the RE/MAX brand as well. RE/MAX is the most recognized real estate company in the world, and that recognition is going to bring you more business. Take a look at these videos produced by one of our top brokers in the Guelph, Mississauga area, Delio Oliveira. They're going to show you the value of the brand and how, if you don't use the brand, it's going to result in you losing business. Check out these videos now.
In a follow-up to the two video series I did on brand, why brand matters, and think before you deviate, I want to share some further considerations and some brand research we've just completed. We outsourced this project to an independent party to do a visual survey on the traditional RE/MAX sign versus different and deviated looking RE/MAX signs without the RE/MAX look of red over white over blue. 500 people, all non-realtors, responded. With four signs to choose from, the survey's main question that we asked was, using your first instinct, which sign is most effective to you as a consumer and why? Here's the results of the survey. 75% said that the compliant RE/MAX sign was most effective. They prefer the RE/MAX look for consumer effectiveness overwhelmingly, even when the RE/MAX compliant sign was put up against not only one other sign, where the compliant sign would have a 50% chance of being chosen, but three other different options. In that survey, with everything being equal, RE/MAX brand compliant sign had only a 25% chance of being chosen. It was nevertheless chosen 75% of the time, even with three other options. What does this mean to you? Well, simply put, before you deviate, I encourage you to think about the preference of the typical consumer and let that drive your decision. I believe the number one reason agents are tempted to deviate, aside from wanting to be different and stand out, is that they perceive that it's about how attractive the logo and the sign are. This is one of the greatest misconceptions about how logos and brand attraction works. And it's the furthest thing from the truth. It's the familiarity and experience with the brand that makes it effective. Let me illustrate. Have you seen the Nike logo, the swoosh? Like, what's attractive about that? The McDonald's arches, the M, what's attractive about that? Look at the Starbucks logo. Talk about maybe not being so attractive. You see, they are effective because of the repetitive nature of building a brand. Because you've seen the swoosh repeatedly over decades, you automatically associate it with Nike, running shoes, sportswear. It's really that simple. So it's not about what's more attractive, trendy, or modern. Logos and brand signage are effective because of the repetitive impressions achieved over decades, with billions of marketing dollars in many cases. So I encourage you to resist the temptation to deviate from the RE/MAX look on your signs and marketing. Stay compliant and use the RE/MAX brand to its full potential in your business. Here's some interesting comments from consumers who chose the brand compliant sign as to why it's the most effective sign for them. One said, "I've seen many of those signs in my community, so I know they can be trusted." Another said, "I've always used RE/MAX Realtors to sell my houses in the past, and I'll probably use them again." Well, here's the interesting thing about this comment. These were all RE/MAX signs, yet the consumer only considered the compliant sign to be RE/MAX. That's very telling in how even a small deviation from the RE/MAX look can have a negative effect on consumer trust and association with the brand. Even brands like Tim Hortons, which is just really a font for a logo, they don't dare change the sign even in the slightest. Why? They don't want the consumer to think something has changed with the product or service. Someone else in the survey said the other signs could be for interior design, contractors, or other businesses, meaning the RE/MAX compliance sign only means real estate. What survey after survey shows us is that your for sale sign needs to be clean and clear. And the two most important elements in your sign is not your website, it's not your phone number, and it's not your tagline. It's your name and the RE/MAX look. This is how you build your brand. Your name is your brand, and you can build that through a consistent and frequent display with the RE/MAX look on your marketing, especially your for sale signs.